22, Revelation 3. He that hath an ear, let him hear what the Spirit saith unto the churches. El que tiene oído, verso 22, oiga lo que el Espíritu dice a las iglesias. And I want us to pray, and I want us to connect with what the Holy Ghost is trying to convey to us here today. Would you open your, not just your mind, but open your spirit, your soul. Open yourself to this word from God, and it will be beneficial to you. Abran su corazón, su espíritu, su alma. Vamos a conectar con la dirección del Espíritu de Dios. Let's pray together. Father, thank you for this moment that you give us, this defining moment. I'm asking you, Lord, to bridge heaven and earth here today and help us to tap into that vein of the Spirit, the will of God concerning your word. Father, I'm asking you, let your word carry out its mission as you have indicated in Isaiah 55. Send your word, let it do that which you have sent it to do, and accomplish it, Lord. We posture ourselves, we assume a posture of good ground here today, that this seed and this word would flourish and germinate within us and change us and direct us. And everybody said in Jesus' name, the Lord bless you. You may be seated. Thank you for standing. Pueden sentarse. Dios les bendiga. Gracias por ponerse de pie en este momento. I am responsible to you, to myself, but to my world and to this great, great church. I'm responsible to make sure that I hear the voice of God. Tengo la responsabilidad a mí, a esta congregación, asegurarme que oigo la voz del Espíritu. That I'm able to sensitize myself through my walk with Him, my relationship with Him, and give you a sure, pure word of God. It's a commitment that I've made. Es mi responsabilidad asegurarme que yo puedo oír claramente y sin ningún problema la voz del Espíritu de Dios y darles a ustedes esa palabra directa del parte del Señor. For that reason, and today, very early this morning, the Lord spoke to me to talk to you a little bit about this. I'm not going to preach my wound open here in my back and all of that. I'm not going to be my regular self. I don't know what's going to happen. I really don't. I don't have stitches anyway. It's glue. They use surgical glue, and I guess it works better than stitches. I don't know, but I'll be all right. If you see red back here, son, just let me know. Praise God. Relax. It's okay. It's going to be okay. No voy a predicar muy fuerte, no quiero que se me abra la herida, pero la realidad es que no tengo puntos, tengo pega aquí atrás. Pero por si acaso, le dije a Ricardo, si ve rojo aquí atrás, pues que me deje saber, pero no se preocupen. Es una broma nada más, es una broma. Praise God. But I am responsible to you, I owe you that. And through the years, I have renewed that commitment to the Lord very frequently. Tengo esa responsabilidad hacia ustedes y durante los años yo he renovado este compromiso y esta promesa con el Señor. I want to make sure that what you are getting from this pulpit, whether it is I or anyone else who stands here, that you get a word from God. And for that reason, the Word of God, the Bible, is the final and supreme authority in this house. It is the final authority in all matters of life, and it is in this house and in this church. Y por esa razón la palabra del Señor, la Sagrada Biblia, la Biblia, la palabra de Dios es la última y final autoridad en todos asuntos de nuestra vida. Y en este lugar, en esta casa, es la autoridad suprema. So, having said that, I made a commitment to God that I would never, ever use the words, thus saith the Lord, as I have operated in the prophetic or in any other dimension that I stand in as a preacher, that I would never use the word thus saith the Lord for personal gain or to manipulate or to in some way or another change the course or direction of a circumstance or cause someone to do something that would be beneficial to me. Do you understand what I'm saying to you? I stand here in the fear of God today as I say that. Prometí al Señor hace mucho tiempo y lo sigo prometiendo que nunca usaré las palabras, dice el Señor, para manipular a alguna persona o tratar de cambiar la dirección de una circunstancia o manipular una circunstancia, mucho menos para mi provecho. Nunca la usaré para tratar de controlar a la gente. I refuse to abuse spiritual authority. You're looking at a very flawed man here today, but I promise you this, I will never, ever abuse the authority God has given me. And nobody can ever point a finger at me and say, I have. I never have. Les prometo esto y les digo, yo soy un hombre fracturado, soy un hombre con muchas flaquezas. Me rehúso a usar la palabra de Dios de esa manera. Me rehúso a abusar la autoridad espiritual que se me ha dado. Nunca lo he hecho y nunca lo haré, y no hay nadie que pueda decir que lo he hecho. But I want you to understand, because today the Lord spoke to me very clearly this morning. Did you ever have God in some way, shape, or form kind of open up a hole in the sky just to let you know he's there? Not necessarily physically, literally, but in some way. It happens to me literally a lot, but I'm just saying this is what happened this morning. ¿Alguna vez el Señor te ha abierto un agujero en el cielo, un hueco en el cielo, solamente para dejarte saber que Él está contigo, que Él está viendo, que Él está a tu lado, si sea simbólicamente o posiblemente literalmente? A mí me ha pasado mucho, me pasa mucho literalmente, y esta mañana eso fue lo que ocurrió. I felt Him very clearly say to me to tell you, to express to you the importance more than ever in this season to know His voice, to know what He's saying to you individually and to us as a church. Esta mañana me lo dio claramente que les expresara a ustedes la importancia que Él quiere que le demos a oír su voz, a oír su voz y definir esa voz en esta temporada en la que estamos, y no solamente como individuos, pero como el cuerpo de Cristo, como la iglesia. And so throughout the years, his voice has become very clear to me. It has become very clear. It didn't just happen. You know, those things happen when we get intentional about knowing Him. Y durante los años he podido aprender a oír su voz, y mucho más claramente hoy que antes. Y eso no pasa a no ser que intencionalmente, con intención, uno cultive y busque de Dios. I have sought Him all hours of the day and night. I love Him. And I don't know everything about Him, but I can tell you here today very humbly and in the fear of the Lord that I do know His voice. And He's calling all of us to a whole new level of understanding and clarity when it comes to knowing His voice. How many want to know His voice? I certainly do. I want to know the voice of God. Y por esa razón les digo hoy, más que nunca, conozco su voz. Es algo que he cultivado, y en el temor de Dios les digo que la conozco. Pero también sé que no lo conozco todo, no lo conozco a Él entera y completamente, pero sí sé su voz, la he oído, la reconozco. So today I'm reaching for you, He's reaching for you and to you through me to tell you that He wants you to have that ear that we just read about here in Revelation, to hear what the Spirit is saying to the church, to hear what the Spirit is saying to us individually. Are you listening? Y por esa razón hoy el Señor me está usando para comunicarte, para extenderse hacia ti, a decirte que hay que tener ese oído. Hay que tener ese oído para que el que oiga lo que el Espíritu dice a las iglesias, que le está diciendo a esta iglesia en particular. I've been mentored by the best, in my opinion, God, my pastor, and the men of God who speak into my life regularly and have throughout the years. I count these great, great men who swim in very deep, deep waters, men who have had a word for me from God throughout my ministry and who have impacted me deeply, and I still answer to those men, and I've been very blessed. So I stand here again, once again, saying to you, this is so important that we know the voice of authority, of spiritual authority in our lives. And because God speaks through that as well. I got a few amens and a few looks, but it's okay. It's the truth anyway. I'll prove it to you in the book in just a moment. Durante los años y mis años de ministerio, he sido mentorado por grandes varones de Dios, hombres que navegan aguas profundas, mucho más profundas de las que yo he navegado. Hombres que han hablado a mi vida el consejo de Dios, el consejo del Espíritu de Dios. Y en ello he crecido y he aprendido también yo a hacer lo mismo. Y de esa manera también el Señor nos está comunicando aquí hoy la importancia de someternos a la autoridad espiritual que Él nos ha dado y ha puesto sobre nuestras vidas. So today my message is very simply, let's go deeper. But we can't go deeper without knowing His voice. Mi mensaje hoy es simple, vamos más profundo, pero no podemos ir más profundo sin conocer su voz. Do you know the voice of the Spirit of God? ¿Conoces la voz del Espíritu de Dios? Sometimes we think we do, but we don't. And when we're not sure, sometimes we align ourselves with voices that we consider to be spiritual, and in reality they are not. Let me say this to you as kindly as I can. Creemos a veces que conocemos la voz del Espíritu de Dios, y a veces cuando no estamos seguros nos alineamos con aquellos que pensamos que pueden ser una voz espiritual en nuestra vida. Let me say this to you. There's a lot of good people with good intentions that want to say wonderful things to you, but it's not the counsel of God. Hay gente maravillosa, amistades, personas que tienen buenas intenciones y te quieren decir algo y aconsejar, pero no es siempre el consejo o la palabra de Dios. You got to be careful. Sometimes we look at somebody who flutters around talking in tongues and they just look like they are connected. And they're about as spiritual as that speaker right there. Bishop has spoken. And I'm not done. Hay gente que andan flotando como una mariposa hablando en lenguas de un lado al otro, y tú dices y piensas, porque lo que ves te da a entender o crees que son gente espiritual, pero te voy a decir, no son todos así. Algunos son tan espirituales como esa bocina. So you have to know for yourself, and you have to be intentional about knowing the voice of God. Tienes que saber para ti mismo y por ti mismo. Y tienes que hacerlo con intención. Tienes que hacerlo adrede. Here it is. He that hath an ear. He that hath an ear. Do you have an ear? Everybody has an ear. But is that ear tuned into the Spirit, capital S, Spirit of God, or another spirit? El que tiene oído, todos tenemos oído, pero la pregunta es, ¿está entonado ese oído al Espíritu de Dios, mayúscula, E mayúscula, o no cualquier otro espíritu? Because Paul said, there's a lot of noise out there, 1 Corinthians. He said, there's a lot of sounds that go forth into the spirit world, into the from, they go to and fro, they move about. Sound waves of all kinds. The spirit world is constantly chattering. Pablo dijo que hay sonidos, hay voces que se mueven en las regiones del espíritu. Continuamente hay sonido, hay voces. Hay palabras que se están hablando y diciendo. He said, none of them is without signification. Y dijo Pablo, Y todas, ninguna de ellas es sin algún significado. What that means is that word means that every one of them has a purpose, has a message, but he was also implying it's not all the right message. Y lo que Pablo estaba diciendo es que esos sonidos, esas voces, tienen un mensaje. Significan algo, están comunicando algo, pero no todo lo que comunican es correcto. And for that reason, it is not my responsibility or Pastor Rick's responsibility or anybody else. It's your responsibility, We can only train and teach you, but you've got to get on your knees for yourself. You've got to make the connection with God. The Word, the pulpit, and the Spirit work together to help you understand. And I'm not teaching on that today. Pastor Rick already taught about and preached about that. Pero no es ni mi responsabilidad ni ningún otro pastor o ministro. Es para nosotros, te podemos mentorar, pero tú tienes que arrodillarte, tú tienes que cultivar una combinación de la palabra de Dios y del púlpito y del Espíritu de Dios, y esas tres tienen que estar de acuerdo. The three will agree. You're not obligated to hear me or do anything I tell you if I can't back it in the book. Tú no estás obligado a obedecerme o oír nada que te diga, excepto si está conectado en ese libro. But because sometimes when the Spirit speaks, it is not to our taste or our flavor, or it assaults our comfort zone. It assaults our carnality, which we cherish and nurture. And don't want it to get its hair messed up. Pero muchas veces porque el Espíritu habla y va en contra de tu carnalidad, la que tú cuidas y cultivas y proteges y no quieres que nadie te la despeine. I do that a lot harder. I'm just testing my wound. Care. Thank you. We are not, what we'll do is we'll go look for other voices until we find the voice that agrees with us. So we can feed our will and our unwillingness to be obedient to the voice of the Spirit, capital S. Somebody ought to say amen to that. Y lo que hacemos es nos ponemos a buscar a ver qué otra voz podemos agarrar del aire. Que se ponga de acuerdo con mi desacuerdo. Y así entonces yo pueda cuidar mi voluntad y mis propios deseos. The call is to go deep. The call is to swim beyond the barrier reef, outside of that harbor that's so safe and secure, and start looking and launching out into the deep where we can see His wonders. El llamado es salir de la bahía, de la seguridad de esas aguas calmas, y empezar a navegar los mares profundos de donde se encuentran y donde nos entretejemos con sus maravillas. And that takes sometimes breaking out of the pack. That takes launching out sometimes beyond the mediocre, beyond the norm, beyond the status quo. Pero eso requiere separarse del montón, separarse del grupo, de impulsarse más allá de lo mediocre, de los promedios, de lo regular, de la regularidad, y salir más allá. And so, we got to assume, we got to take on this posture of listening. We need to listen. And we need to run it by the man of God. We need to run it by the book, first, the man of God. We need to make sure. Had a dream? Be careful. Think you had a vision? Be careful. Both of them are good. God does both. But not all of them. Your mind is a wonderful thing, but it is not always the mind of Christ that's fabricating your visions and dreams. Can I get an amen? Tienes que tener cuidado, sueños, visiones. Sí, Dios las da, los dos, y son buenos, pero no todos son de Dios. Tu mente es algo maravilloso, pero no siempre es la mente de Cristo. Así que ten cuidado. Ten mucho cuidado. I need to know And God said, in this season, you are at a defining moment as a church and as individuals. Much transition, many things. And as we come into this other season that we're about to step through, He is going to, and this is what He said to me this morning, I'm going to intensify my communication, the regularity, the intensity. I am going to be clearer than I've ever been if you will assume a posture to be the best listener you can be. Y en esta temporada, en este punto estratégico en el que nos encontramos, ya a punto de entrar a otra dimensión, a otra temporada, el Señor está diciendo y me dijo, diles, estoy a punto de empezar a comunicarme con más intensidad de lo que lo he hecho anteriormente, con más claridad y con más frecuencia, y necesito que tomen una postura de oír como nunca antes. Aprendan a oír. Aprendan a oír. John 10. Ruben, did you get my text? Do you have a cue? Did you have that queued up? That video? Hold on for it. Hold it. I want to read a verse of scripture, and then I want you to watch this. John 10. You do not have it? Pause for a commercial break. Ship this to somebody up there. John 10. Shh. Easy. San Juan capítulo 10. Look here. Listen. Verse 4. And when he putteth forth his own sheep, he goeth before them, and the sheep follow him, for they know his voice. Cuando saca todas las suyas, verso 4, va delante de ellas y las ovejas lo siguen porque conocen su voz. Verse 5. And a stranger will they not follow, but will flee from him, for they know not the voice of strangers. Pero a un desconocido no seguirán, sino que huirán de él, porque no conocen la voz de los extraños. I'm preaching to you about going deeper, but you cannot go deep, at least not in the right direction, until you're connected to the voice of God. Estoy predicándote acerca de ir más profundo, pero no puedes ir a las profundidades correctas sin estar conectado a la voz del Espíritu de Dios. We need to know what he's saying. Tenemos que saber lo que dice. It's paramount. Romans 8:14. As many as are led by the Spirit of God. They are the sons, daughters. They are the children of God. So it's relationship that we're talking about here. Romanos 8 y 14. En cuanto son los que son dirigidos o guiados por el Espíritu de Dios, serán los hijos de Dios, hijas de Dios. Y eso se trata de una relación. I'm preaching to you, go deeper, but you got to know his voice. Ve más profundo, pero tienes que conocer su voz. We got it? Look here.
Time.
Understand. My sheep know my voice. Mis ovejas conocen mi voz. Now stand with me right now. Because today God wants to usher you into a new level of sensitivity to that voice of His Spirit. Lift your hands today. Hoy levanten sus manos, pónganse de pie, porque Dios quiere infundirles con una sensibilidad más. What I want you to do is say, God, I want to know. Don't do it if you don't want to hear the voice of God. But if you're wanting to move into that place where that clarity is just that, so clear, lift your hands right now. He's going to put something in your spirit today that's going to embark you on a journey that's going to help you understand when you hear His voice and when it's the voice of a stranger. In the name of Jesus, hoy te va a infundir el Señor. Hoy te va a llevar en una jornada donde te va a enseñar a oír su voz y también discernir la voz del extraño. Go ahead and reach for heaven today. Reach for heaven today. We've got to know His voice. In the name of Jesus, receive this right now. En el nombre de Jesús, recíbelo en este momento. I've got to have it, Lord. I've got to have it at the house. I've got to have it at work. I've got to have it in this world that I walk in. Everywhere I set foot, God, I don't want to miss an opportunity. I don't want to miss a directive. Tengo que tenerlo, Señor, en mi hogar. Tengo que tenerlo en el trabajo. Donde quiera que ponga pie, Señor, no puedo perder oportunidades. No puedo perder oportunidades. In Jesus' name, in Jesus' name, in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name, stay standing with me. I'm only going to take you halfway through the message and the lesson today. And next Sunday I will finish, but I have a couple more things to say as the musicians play softly. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. In Jesus' name, we are being called to a deeper commitment to the word, the written word, the logos that Pastor Rick was talking about. Estamos siendo llamados a un compromiso más profundo con la palabra de Dios, la palabra escrita, el logos de Dios, como dijo el Pastor Ricardo. Too many of us are in a famine when it comes to this book. We are starving. We're not in the book even daily. We're living off of sermons on the radio and television and getting our spirit tickled by every kind of word that comes out there. Sounds good, cliches. Maybe some of it's good in that buffet, but let me tell you something. You can't replace the word with that kind of stuff. You got to know the word, because some of the stuff they're telling you, you're believing and you're not even lining it up with the book because you don't know what the book says. Estás muriéndote de hambre de la palabra de Dios. Piensas que solamente porque hay televangelistas y radioevangelistas que eso es suficiente, y andas oyendo y te hacen cosquillas a tu espíritu y te hablan de cosas, que estás creyendo cosas que no sabes si son la verdad o no, pero las crees y no sabes si se alinean con la palabra, porque no conoces la palabra, y no la conoces porque no la lees, no la estudias, no la escudriñas. Study to show thyself approved. Estudia para que seas aprobado de Dios. Estúdialo. Study. We have a lot of problems with getting convictions about some things that are clear in the book. Because we're not in the book. And this is the author of our convictions is right here. This book is the final authority of our convictions. What we're getting is preferences from what we're listening everywhere else. We're grabbing preferences. You want convictions about stuff? Why we preach so hard about some stuff? Because it's in the book. Settle the question. I challenge you to move from your preferences to conviction. Good, hardcore, spiritual, biblical conviction. Settle some matters about holiness. Settle some matters about the doctrine. Settle some matters about stuff. We're in the book here, people. Te desafío hoy como nunca antes te desafío. El problema es que vivimos solamente con nuestras preferencias. Pero este libro, esta palabra de Dios es la autoridad final en todo y es el autor de toda convicción. El resto son los que te dan tus preferencias. Pero te desafío a que te muevas de preferencias a convicciones. Pero eso nunca va a pasar hasta que veas lo que dice esta palabra. Aquí se predica la palabra. Ya establece tus convicciones. En cuanto a la doctrina, la santidad, todas esas cosas están en el libro, amados. We need to go deeper. You got to know the word. You got to know his voice. We pray. We're about to engage our first 40-day fast for the new year. Some of you are opening your spirit up through fasting, but you're not feeding yourself the right stuff and you're making yourself vulnerable to anything that floats out there in the spirit world. You're supposed to eat the word, not junk. Vamos a empezar ese ayuno de 40 días del año nuevo, el primer ayuno de 40 días. Tú ayunas a veces, pero abres tu espíritu y te haces vulnerable, pero no te alimentas lo correcto durante ese ayuno. Y abres tu espíritu a la basura que anda flotando en las regiones del espíritu. Don't you know that in the spirit realm, there's a lot of junk floating around, waiting to find an opening in your soul, waiting to find a place to reside and to grow within you. ¿No sabes que hay basura que flota en las regiones del espíritu buscando dónde encontrar su lugar, su nuevo hogar para meterse ahí y dar sus raíces en tu vida, en tu alma? But when I open my spirit and I'm filling that opening with the Holy Spirit of God, the sacred word of God, and I am making sure that my preaching and teaching is lined up, there is no room for anything else. Pero cuando ayuno y abro mi espíritu a la sagrada palabra de Dios, al espíritu de Dios, a la prédica que se alinea con esta sagrada palabra, no hay espacio para que alguna otra cosa se meta. You see, there are no spaces for rent in here. Some of your battles is because you're renting rooms to the wrong spirit. Was that too harsh? Let me say it with a little more love. Some of your battles are because you're renting rooms. Bad things. Mijo. Mija. Lift lift your hands once more. I'm stopping here. Part two next Sunday. I'm going to open this altar for you to find a place on your knees to let what you have heard today to find its place, a productive place inside of you to grow and to effect change. Today you have an opportunity to have a defining spiritual event. Hoy abro este altar para que te arrodilles y cultives lo que has recibido hasta este punto. Hoy se te ofrece una oportunidad para tener un evento espiritual definido. Next week, I'm going to hit you with the meat of this message. But if you'll take the foundational stuff today, next week we'll hit the meat. Hoy te di lo fundamental. La semana que viene te doy la carne de este mensaje. The altar is open. This is your service now. This is your time to work this word. Grab it and keep it. Don't check it at the door when you leave. Take it with you. Este es tu momento, este es tu servicio para que tú cultives, para que tú tomes esta palabra y le des su lugar. No lo dejes en la puerta cuando salgas. Úsalo, hazlo parte de tu vida.